Okay, so you have to note this point that the value of a fraction remains the same if both its numerator and denominator are multiplied or divided by the same non-zero number. Okay, they are called like fractions. Okay, and the fraction must always be expressed in its lowest term. For example, if we have 15 upon 35, correct? We can write it as 5 into 3 divided by 7 into 3. So we can cancel out 3, which is the common multiplier of the numerator as well as denominator, and we get 5 upon 7. So 5 upon 7 is called as the lowest term, okay? The lowest ratio. And 15 upon 35 and 5 upon 7 are called like fractions. What are they called? Like fractions. जसं लाईक टर्म्स असतात तसं लाईक फ्रॅक्शन्स असतात. सो द 5/7 इज द लोएस्ट टर्म अँड 15/35 अँड 5/7 आर कॉल्ड ॲज लाईक फ्रॅक्शन्स. ओके, सो यू कॅन नोट डाऊन दिस पॉइंट अँड यू कॅन से यू कॅन राईट दिस वन एक्झाम्पल. ओके, फर्स्ट एक्झाम्पल लिहून घ्या अँड राईट दिस सेकंड पॉइंट ऑल्सो. अ फ्रॅक्शन मस्ट ऑलवेज बी एक्सप्रेस्ड इन इट्स लोएस्ट टर्म. Okay. All right. The next topic is reducing a given fraction to its lowest term. Okay. We just saw what lowest term is. So if you are given a fraction, you will be able to reduce it to the lowest term. Correct. So let us take an example. Reduce 48 upon 60 to its lowest term. So what you will do, you will take a common factor from this. Okay, HCF, it is called as HCF, highest common factor. Correct? So the highest common factor of 48 and 60 is 12. Okay, I'll show you one another method that is called alternative method. If you find that simple, you can use that method also. Okay? So finding LCM, I think you are quite familiar with that. So finding the HCF also. So if you find the HCF of two numbers, you can divide both the numerator as well as denominator by their HCF, and then you get the lowest term. Okay, so the HCF of 48 and 60 here is 12. So 48 divided by 12 divided by 60 divided by 12, correct? And you get 4 upon 5. But in the alternative method, what you can do is you can find the prime factors of both the numerator as well as denominator. Okay, so let's see 48. The prime factors are 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. Okay, prime factorization method. And the prime factors of 60 are 2 into 2 into 3 into 5. Now 48 upon 60 can be written as 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3, that is prime factors of the number 48 on the numerator, divided by 2 into 2 into 3 into 5. Now you can cancel out the common factors. Okay, you can cancel out two twos and one three. So you are left with 2 into 2 in the numerator and 5 in the denominator. So again you get 4 upon 5 as the simplest term. Okay, are you following this? Can we use alternative method for 18 upon 27? Of course we can. What are the factors of 18? 2 into 3 into 3, correct? Upon what are the factors of 27? 3 into 3 into 3. So you can cancel out these two threes and you will get 2 by 3, correct? So 2 upon 3 is the simplest form of 18 upon 27, correct? Okay, so what are equivalent fractions? In the last lecture, I told you about equivalent fractions. Right now also, I told you equivalent fractions. Like 15 upon 35 and 3 upon, sorry, 15 upon 35 and 3 upon 7. These are equivalent fractions. 4 upon 10. okay, is same as a 2/5, is same as 8/20. Okay, these are called equivalent fractions. They are not equal, the numbers are not equal, but the simplest ratio of all of them is 2/5. Okay, the simplest ratio in this, the first example is 3/7. Okay, so if the simplest ratio of the fractions is same, then they are called as equivalent fractions. They are not equal, they are equivalent. Okay, fractions having the same value are called equivalent fractions. 20/25 is 4/5. 28/35 is also 4/5. 20/25 and 28/35 are equivalent fractions. Okay, so you can write this equal also, not a problem. 20/25 is equal to 28/35 is equal to 4/5. Then simple and complex fractions. Okay, simple fractions are composed of integers. Both the numerator and denominator are integers. They are called simple fractions. Okay, by definition they are simple fractions. Whereas a fraction whose numerator or denominator or both are not integers, but they are mixed fractions, or they are fractions themselves or even decimal numbers, then they are called as complex fractions. Okay, you can see the example. Simple fraction 3/8, -10/17. Negative numbers are allowed. 8/-15, because they are integers, they are called simple fractions. What are complex fractions? 5/2/3. We will see how to deal with this later on. 1/4/8, 9/14/2/3/7, okay, etc. are called complex fractions. Okay, have you followed this? Okay, all right. We'll start with the exercise. Exercise 3A. Classify each fraction given below as decimal or vulgar fraction, proper or improper fraction, and mixed fraction. Okay, 3/5. What type of fraction is this?
Proper fraction.
Okay, it is a proper fraction, and it is decimal or vulgar? Kutla hai?
Vulgar.
Correct, vulgar. So it is proper and vulgar fraction. Correct. 11/10.
Decimal fraction.
Correct. It is a decimal fraction, and it is proper or improper?
Improper.
Correct. Improper. Because numerator is greater than denominator. Okay. 13/20.
Proper and vulgar.
Proper and vulgar. Correct. See, what is vulgar? If the denominator is not a multiple of 10 or a power 10 or a power of 10, then it is a vulgar fraction. What is a decimal fraction? If the denominator is 10 or a power of 10, then it is a decimal fraction. Okay. 18/7.
Improper and vulgar.
Correct. Improper and vulgar. 3/2/9.
Mixed and vulgar.
Correct. Mixed and vulgar. Very good. Question 2. Express the following improper fractions as mixed fractions. Okay. We'll do a few of these, and I'll give the rest for the homework. Okay. We'll do the 18/5. These are improper fractions. So what do you do? You'll divide it by 5. 18/5. What do you get? 5 3s are 15. So you get remainder as 3. Correct. Remainder kiti ala? 3 ala. So how do you write this? Kasa lihto apan sanga?
3 3 5. It is 3 integer 3/5.
Ha. So you write it in this format. Dividend into quotient plus remainder divided by the dividend. Okay, you write like this. 18/5 is equal to dividend. 5 is the divisor. dividend nahi, divisor. So 18 upon 5, 5 divisor into quotient plus remainder divided by the divisor. Asa lihayacha adi, then you separate. Okay, you separate the denominator. Asa karayacha. Now you can cancel out this. 5 and 5 cancel karu shakta. So you get 3 plus 3 upon 5. And then you can write 3, 3 fifth. Okay, this is the procedure, standard procedure. If you follow this, all these steps, then you will get full marks. Asach karayacha, adi divide karayacha, then you should write in this format. And then cancel out and separate the denominator, cancel out, and then you'll arrive at the final answer. Okay, please write this down. I'll do the third one. 25 divided by 6. 6 fours are 24.
4 integer 1 upon 6.
So you'll write 25 upon 6 is equal to 6 into 4 divisor into quotient plus remainder upon divisor. Now you will separate this. Separate the denominator. You can cancel out 6 easily. And you get 4 plus 1 upon 6 or 4 1 sixth. Okay, so you get 4 1 sixth. Third one. We'll do the fifth one now. 22 divided by 5. 5 fours are 20.
4 integer 2 upon 5.
Correct. So 22 upon 5 is written as the divisor 5 into quotient, which is 4, plus the remainder 2 upon the divisor 5. So you will write 5 into 4 upon 5. 5 will get cancelled plus 2 upon 5. So you get 4 plus 2 upon 5, which is 4 2 fifth. Okay. This should be the answer. Okay, then question 3. Express the following mixed fractions as improper fractions. Okay, we'll do the first one. Achi method ka hai baga? 2, 4, 9. 2, 4 by 9 is equal to 2 into 9 plus 4 upon 9. Okay, exactly reverse procedure. So 2 9s are 18 plus 4 upon 9. You have to show all the steps. Huh? Don't skip any of the steps. You get 22 upon 9 as the improper fraction. Then third one. 3 1 4th is written as 3 into 4 plus 1 upon 4. So you get 3 plus 1 upon 4. So 13 upon 4. Kalla?
Oh, sir.
Okay, we'll do the fifth one now. Okay, apan ithe odd karuya, even numbers je problems hai, te tumhi homework la try kara. Fifth, 12, 7 by 11. So we'll write 12 into 11 plus 7 upon 11. 12 into 11 is how much? 132.
132.
Correct. Plus 7 upon 11. So you get 139 upon 11. That's it. Okay. Question 4. Reduce the given fractions to their lowest terms. First, 8 upon 18. So we'll follow the alternative method, which is finding the prime factors and then canceling out the common factors. Okay. So what are the prime factors of 8? 2 into 2 into 2.
Yes.
What are the prime factors of 18? 2 into 3 into 3. Correct. So you can cancel out only 1, 2, which is common between 8 and 18. So you get 4. 2 into 2 is 4.
4 upon 9.
Upon 3 into 3 is 9. Correct. So 4 upon 9. Okay. Third, 18 upon 42. So 18 upon 42 can be written as 2 into 3 into 3. As prime factors of 18, and 42 can be written as 2 into 3 into 7. So you can cancel out 1, 2 and 1, 3. So you get 3 by 7. This is the simplest form. Okay, then fifth, 18 upon 45. So again, 18 upon 45 can be written as 2 into 3 into 3. And 45 is divisible by 3 first, 3 into 3 into 5. So you can cancel out two 3s here. Okay, and you are left with 2 upon 5. So 2 upon 5 is the lowest term. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Finished? Zala Leon? Okay. All right. Question five. True or false? So, 30 upon 40 and 12 upon 16 are equivalent fractions. Now, what are equivalent fractions again? If their least term or the lowest term is the same, then they are called as equivalent fractions. So, 30 upon 40. Okay. That's upon least ratio find out Korea. You can write this as 2 into 3 into 5. Okay. हे त्याचे काय आहेत prime factors आहेत. And 40 चे prime factor किती आहेत? 2 into 2 into 2 into 5. 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8, 8 5 is 40. Correct. So you can cancel out 2, you can cancel out 5. So you are left with 3 upon 4. Again, 12 upon 16. What are the prime factors? 2 into 2 into 3. And here you have 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. So you can cancel out two 2s here and you will get 3 upon 4. So both of these fractions have the same least term and hence they are called as equivalent fractions. Okay. Lya as 30 upon 40 is equal to 3 by 4 and 12 upon 16 is also 3 by 4. Therefore, 30 upon 40 and 12 upon 16 are equivalent fractions. Okay, just don't directly tumhi lihu shakta true or false. Yes, the question is only true or false. Then you can write it. But samjha mi tumhala question vicharla ki are they equivalent fractions? Then you should show these steps to be on the safer side. Okay, हे सगळे स्टेप्स
ट्रू ऑर फॉल्स तर मी या सगळे स्टेप्स दाखवायला लागतो.
व्हाट इज दिस? दिस इज ट्रू. दिस इज ट्रू. सेकंड, 10 अपॉन 25 एंड 25 अपॉन 10 आर इक्विवेलेंट फ्रॅक्शन्स. व्हाट डू यू थिंक? नो, 10 अपॉन 25 इज 2 इंटू 5 अपॉन 5 इंटू 5. यू कॅन कॅन्सल आउट 1 5 अँड यू गेट 2 अपॉन 5. Whereas 25 upon 10,
sir, they are not equivalent.
5 upon 2, exactly. They are reciprocals of each other rather. So it is false. They are not. 35 upon 49, 20 upon 28, 45 upon 63 and 100 upon 140 are equivalent fractions. Okay, we'll do one by one quickly. 35 upon 49 can be written as 5 into 7 upon 7 into 7. You can cancel out 7, you get 5 upon 7. Then 20 upon 28. Me quickly karto. 4 into 5 upon 4 into 7. Correct? 4 cancel. You get again 5 upon 7. You again 45 upon 63. 5 nines are. Okay. And 6. 7 nines are 63. So 7 into 9. So again 9 cancel. You get 5 upon 7. And finally 100 upon 140. Is again the same thing, correct? 5 into 20 upon 7 into 20. 20 cancelled out, you get 5 upon 7. So yes, they are equivalent fractions because they all have their least term as 5 upon 7. Hence, it is true. Question 6. Distinguish each of the fractions given below as a simple fraction or a complex fraction. 0 upon 8.
Simple fraction.
Simple. Minus 3 upon minus 8.
Oh, complex.
सिंपल इंटीजर्स आहेत ते, सिंपल नेगेटिव आलं म्हणून काही फरक पडत नाही. 5/-7
सिंपल
सिंपल. 3/5/18
कॉम्प्लेक्स
कॉम्प्लेक्स. -6/2 2/5
कॉम्प्लेक्स
कॉम्प्लेक्स. 3/1/7 2/7 कॉम्प्लेक्स.
कॉम्प्लेक्स
-5/2/9/5
कॉम्प्लेक्स.
कॉम्प्लेक्स. -8/0
सिंपल सिंपल
इज नाइदर अ सिंपल फ्रैक्शन नॉर अ कॉम्प्लेक्स फ्रैक्शन बिकॉज इट इज झिरो. ऑब्जर्व, झिरो नी डिवाइड होत नाही मैथ्स मध्ये, सांगितलंय ना. डिनोमिनेटर ऑब्जर्व करा नेहमी. इट इज नाइदर अ सिंपल फ्रैक्शन नॉर अ कॉम्प्लेक्स फ्रैक्शन, रादर इट इज एन एब्सर्ड नंबर. एब्सर्ड नंबर है हा, नॉट डिफाइंड. दिस नंबर इज नॉट डिफाइंड बिकॉज झिरो इज इन द डिनोमिनेटर. डझंट मॅटर वॉट इज इन द न्यूमरेटर, डझंट मॅटर ऍब्सोल्युटली. न्यूमरेटरला झिरो असू दे, मायनस नंबर असू दे, ऑर पॉझिटिव्ह इंटीजर असू दे, नाही तर निगेटिव्ह इंटीजर असू दे. इफ देर इज झिरो इन द डिनोमिनेटर देन इट इज नॉट डिफाइंड, रिमेंबर ऑलवेज. ओके, सो वॉट इज इम्पॉर्टंट इन द फ्रॅक्शन, द डिनॉमिनेटर इज इम्पॉर्टंट. ओके, डिनॉमिनेटरकडे आधी लक्ष द्या तुम्ही. सो हे फक्त एक नोट लिहून घ्या. Each of the numbers of the form, whatever the form is, if the denominator is zero, then it is neither a simple fraction nor a complex fraction, as the division by zero is not defined. Okay, please write this down. Okay. Like and unlike fractions. See, like and unlike fractions are quite similar to equivalent. Rather, equivalent fractions are always like fractions. Okay, magashi mi word use kela like fraction. But equivalent fractions are always like fractions. But all like fractions are may not be equivalent fractions. Okay, so what to look for a like fraction, like term sarkha asto, like fraction manje kay? If the denominator
or the numerator is same.
Ha, if the denominator, not numerator, fakt the denominator, numerator nahi. If denominator of all the fractions are same, then they are called as like fractions. Okay, and if the denominators are different, then they are called as unlike fractions. Very simple. Numerator doesn't play any role. I told you, numerator cha far farak nahi padat, denominator cha importance jaast ahe. Okay, so you can write this down, this thing, like fractions. Write the definition, give examples, and then we will go ahead. Okay, now let us see how we can convert like unlike fractions into like fractions. Okay, it's quite easy. We have already done this thing in rational numbers. Okay, same as type ahe. You have to find the LCM of the denominators of all the given fractions. Okay, find the LCM and then the multiply and divide the numerator by that number. You'll get the same denominator. Why do we find LCM? To make the denominator same. Okay, to make the denominator equal of all the fractions. For each given fraction, multiply its denominator by a suitable number so that the product obtained is equal to the LCM obtained in step one. Multiply the numerator also by the same number. If you divide the numerator, multiply the denominator, you have to multiply the numerator also. So let's see this example and you'll get the clear idea. Okay, so we have been given 3/4, 3/5, 7/8 and 9/16. If you observe, the denominators are different for all of these fractions, two like fractions. So what is the LCM of 4, 5, 8 and 16? Take all the denominators and find the LCM. What is the LCM of 4, 5, 8 and 16? 80. तुम्हाला एलसीएम काढता येतो ना प्राइम फॅक्टरायझेशन मेथडनी? येतो ना? हा, गुड. सो इफ यू फाइंड द एलसीएम इट इज 80. नाव हाऊ डू यू कन्वर्ट 4 × 80? यू विल मल्टीप्लाय बाय 20 ऑफकोर्स. सो यू विल हॅव टू मल्टीप्लाय द न्यूमरेटर ऑल्सो बाय 20 अँड यू गेट 60/80. अगेन 3/5, हाऊ डू यू गेट 80 फ्रॉम 5? यू विल मल्टीप्लाय बाय 16. So we'll multiply the numerator also by 16. So you get 40/80. then you have 7 upon 8. How do you get 80 from 8? You will multiply by 10. So you will multiply the numerator also by 10. So you get 70 upon 80. And finally, 9 by 16. How do you get 80 from 16? You will multiply by 5. So you will multiply the numerator also by 5. So you get 45 upon 80. Okay. So these are the like fractions because their denominator is same. Is it clear? 100%?
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right. Let's see comparing fractions. We have already done that comparing fraction. तर कंपेरिंग फ्रॅक्शन मध्ये बरं त्याच्या आधी मला एक सांगायचं होतं. द थिंग इज इफ आय गिव्ह यू समथिंग लाईक दिस हा मायनस टू वन थर्ड हे नाहीये टेक्स्टबुक मध्ये पण सांगायला पाहिजे. हाऊ डू यू कन्वर्ट इट इन टू इम्प्रॉपर फ्रॅक्शन. द थिंग इज आपल्याला काय वाटतं हे मायनस टू आहे हे नाहीये तसं ऍक्च्युली. दिस मायनस साईन इज फॉर द एंटायर नंबर. ओके so what do? You keep the minus sign aside. Minus sign bazula theva and you do the regular calculation. 2 multiplied by 3 plus 1 upon 3 and you get minus 6 plus 1 upon 3. So you get minus 7 upon 3. Okay, it seems quite simple or easy but kai kai velela chuk hoti. For example, mula kay kartat? Minus 2 into 3 kartat. मायनस टू वन थर्ड दिलंय मायनस टू इंटू थ्री प्लस वन अपॉन थ्री. दिस इज अ कॉमन मिस्टेक अँड व्हॉट हॅपन्स इज मायनस टू इंटू थ्री इज मायनस सिक्स प्लस वन अपॉन थ्री अँड यू गेट अँसर मायनस फाय अपॉन थ्री विच इज रॉंग. ओके दिस शुड नॉट हॅपन असं नसतं मिक्स फ्रॅक्शनचं कॅल्क्युलेशन. सो ऑलवेज रिमेंबर इफ दिस अपियर्स इन युअर एक्झाम ऑर एनी टाइम इन फ्युचर ऑलवेज कीप द नेगेटिव्ह साईन असाइड. Take the negative sign, away from the main calculations and then put it back. मग minus 7 upon 3 answer आलं पाहिजे पण येतं काय वेळेला काय minus 5 upon 3. This is wrong. This हे असं होत नाही मॅथ्स मध्ये. हा एक कॉमन मिस्टेक आहे तर असं तुम्ही करू नका असं मला सांगायचं होतं. तर तुम्ही हे एक एक्झाम्पल इम्पॉर्टंट म्हणून लिहून घ्या. देन वी विल गो फॉर कम्पेरिंग फ्रॅक्शन्स. हॅव यू फॉलोड दिस? Okay. Just remember this thing. All right. So now comparing fractions. This is similar to comparing the rational numbers. Okay. Which one is greater? But here if there are only two numbers to compare, then you can use the cross multiplication method. If you remember, okay, 2 into 4, and then 3 into 3. So you get 8 and 9. So obviously 8 is smaller than 9. And then you can say 2 by 3. So left la number ahe to smaller hai. 2 by 3 is less than 3 by 4. This can be done when there are only two numbers. Cross multiplication method can be used only efficiently. It can be used, but it can be used efficiently if there are only two numbers. But suppose 4 fractions or 5, 6 fractions are given to arrange them in ascending or descending order for comparison. Then it's better to find their LCM. So it's better to write the like fractions and then compare the numerators. Because once you convert those into like fractions, the denominators are same throughout. Denominator सगळीकडे same येतात पण numerator मग आता तुम्हाला compare करायचे असतात. You can compare the numerators and then you can compare the fractions. Okay. So let's say we have this question. Compare the fractions 2 by 3, 3 by 4, 5 by 12 and 9 by 16. So LCM of the denominators 3, 4, 12 and 16 is 48. LCM tumhi find out kela. Now 2 by 3 can be converted by multiplying the numerator and denominator by 16. So you get 32 by 48. 3 by 4 can be written as 36 by 48. 5 upon 12 can be written as 20 upon 48. And 9 upon 16 can be written as 27 upon 48. So basically we have converted all the fractions into like fractions. Now since the denominator is same, you can compare the numerators very easy. The numerator matla kutla number greater hai? Which number is greatest? Greatest and smallest. Kutla hai greatest? 36 करेक्ट आणि त्याच्यानंतर कुठला आहे 32 देन यू हॅव 27 अँड देन यू हॅव 20 सो बेसिकली 36/48 करेक्ट इज ग्रेटर राईट दॅन 32/48 इज ग्रेटर दॅन 27/48 इज ग्रेटर दॅन 20/48
सर पण ते 2/3 वगैरे असं लिहावं लागेल ना याच्या
हो हो नाही नाही मी सांगितलं हे तसं लिहायचं आणि मग फायनल आन्सर मध्ये 2/3 लिहायचं कळलं का हे असं लिहा तुम्ही आणि मग फायनल आन्सर मध्ये जे ओरिजिनल नंबर्स आहेत ते लिहायचे सो व्हॉट इज 36/48 3/4 मग लिहा 3/4 ग्रेटर दॅन 32/48 वॉज 2/3 greater than 27/48 was 9/16 greater than and finally 20/48 was 5/12 okay final answer asas lecho is it clear kasa gele kalla
ho sir
okay this is in descending order okay greatest to smallest you can do it in the other way also ओके त्यांनी कम्पेअर म्हणलेलं आहे यू कॅन यूज एनी वन ऑफ द मेथड्स किंवा एक्झाम मध्ये येतं पण दे विल बी क्वेश्चन इन विच इट विल बी मेन्शन्ड अरेंज द नंबर्स अरेंज द फ्रॅक्शन इन टू असेंडिंग ऑर्डर ऑर डिसेंडिंग ऑर्डर फॉर दॅट मॅटर अँड देन यू कॅन राईट इट अकॉर्डिंग
क्वेश्चन आला की कम्पेअर
ऑलराईट we'll see one question in which we will make the numerators equal okay alternate method baga so we can convert all the given fractions into fractions of equal numerators by the way they are not like fractions by definition they cannot be called like fractions the fraction which has a smaller denominator will be greater so 2/3 again 3/4 5/12 9/16 by making numerators equal Now you will find LCM of numerators and not denominators. So the LCM of numerators is 90. So to make 290, you will multiply by 45 and divide by 45 also. So you get 90/135. 3/4 becomes 90/120. 5/12 becomes 90/216. And 9/16 becomes 90/160. So now the numerators are same. The denominator which the fraction whose denominator is smaller will be the greatest fraction. So yes, 120 is smaller, so 3/4 is the greatest. Then we have 135, so 2/3. Then we have 160, so 9/16, and finally 5/12. Okay, the fraction whose denominator is smaller will be the fraction will be greater. Ulta asto ya case madhe. क्लिअर आहे नक्की ओके काय डाऊट नाही आहे ओके ऑलराईट ओके हे त्यांनी दिले बघा लास्ट टाइम सारखं इन ऑर्डर टू कम्पेअर टू फ्रॅक्शन ए अपॉन बी अँड सी अपॉन डी फाइंड देअर क्रॉस प्रॉडक्ट फाइंडिंग ए इन टू डी अँड बी इन टू सी इट्स व्हेरी इझी लेफ्ट आणि राईट त्या प्रकारे आहे ओके हे आलं बघा क्वेश्चन कम्पेअर ओके आठवतंय नेगेटिव्ह साईन न्यूमरेटरला घ्यायची आणि मग मल्टिप्लाय करायचं ओके हे केलं होतं आपण रॅशनल नंबर्स मध्ये रिमेंबर
हो सर
ओके ग्रेट ओके लास्ट टॉपिक आहे इन्सर्ट वन फ्रॅक्शन बिटवीन द टू गिवन फ्रॅक्शन्स एक फ्रॅक्शन इन्सर्ट करायचं आहे दोन दिलेल्या फ्रॅक्शन मध्ये तर त्याच्याला एक सिम्पल मेथड आहे ऍव्हरेज म्हणतो आपण ऍव्हरेज काढायची और मीन काढायचं सो व्हॉट डू वी डू वी हॅव टू फ्रॅक्शन्स 1/2 अँड 3/5 okay we have to insert just one fraction between these two so what do we just add the numerators and denominators okay and we get the answer that's it it evadas karaycha 1+3 = 4 and 2+5 = 7 bas jhala 4/7 automatically lies between 1/2 and 3/5 okay so what is the general rule if a/b is one fraction and c/d is another then a+c/b+d lies between a/b and c/d simple straight away okay also if a/b is greater than c/d then a/b is greater than a+c अपॉन बी प्लस डी ग्रेटर देन सी अपॉन डी और रिवर्स लेस असेल तर लेस. ओके आता हा बघा ऑलवेज रिमेंबर नेव्हर डू कॅल्क्युलेशन युझिंग मिक्स फ्रॅक्शन. कधीही करायचं नाही मिक्स फ्रॅक्शन मध्ये कॅल्क्युलेशन. ओके सो 3 1/2 शुड बी कन्वर्टेड इन टू इम्प्रॉपर फ्रॅक्शन विच इज 7/2. सो यूज द सेम प्रिन्सिपल ए प्लस सी अपॉन बी प्लस डी. सो वी कॅन ऍड 2 + 7 = 9 1 + 2 = 3 बट 9/3 = 3. ओके 3 1s are 3 3s are. सो यस 3 इज द फ्रॅक्शन विच लाइज बिटवीन दीज टू गिवन फ्रॅक्शन.
तर आता तुम्ही म्हणाला की मिक्स फ्रॅक्शन मध्ये कधीही सम्स नाही करायचे. आधी आम्हाला सांगितलं
कॅल्क्युलेशन नाही
हा तर मग आधी आम्हाला हे पण सांगितलं होतं की जर असं सम आहेत.
ओके आता हा बघा इन्सर्ट 3 फ्रॅक्शन्स बिटवीन 1/2 and 3/5. 3 फ्रॅक्शन इन्सर्ट करायचे आहेत आपल्याला. मग काय करणार आता. ओके यू हॅव टू फॉलो दिस स्टेप और यू हॅव टू डू दिस स्टेप 3 times. रिमेंबर 1/2 इज ए अपॉन बी अँड 3/5 सी अपॉन डी. हा सो फर्स्ट स्टेप इज इझी जस्ट ऍड देम यू गेट 1 + 3 = 4 2 + 5 = 7. ठीक आहे आला. सो नाव बेसिकली 1/2 इज ग्रेटर दॅन 4/7 इज ग्रेटर दॅन 3/5 असं असं ते आहे. ओके सिम्पल. नाव ऍक्च्युली उलट 3/5 ग्रेटर आहे 1/2 पेक्षा. ठीक आहे एनिवेज. सो बेसिकली 4/7 लाईज बिटवीन दीज टू नंबर्स. ओके आता काय करायचं. आता या दोघांमधला एक फ्रॅक्शन काढायचा 4/7 आणि 1/2 मधला आणि सेकंडली 3/5 आणि 4/7 मधला काढायचा. झालं. सो यू गेट अनदर 2 फ्रॅक्शन्स. ओके सो नाव फ्रॅक्शन बिटवीन 1/2 and 4/7 इज 1 + 4 divided by 2 + 7 विच इज 5/9. ओके आणि फायनली 4/7 आणि 3/5 मधला या लेफ्ट मधला 4/7 and 3/5 विच इज 4 + 3 / 7 + 5 = 7/12. झालं. सो व्हाट आर द 3 रिक्वायर्ड फ्रॅक्शन्स. 5/9 4/7 and 7/12. कळलंय नक्की हाऊ टू डू दिस.